This is GameStop, an American video game chain that's been hit hard both by the pandemic and the rise of online rivals. With expected store closures in the thousands, GameStop is circling the drain, yet has somehow just become the hottest stock on Wall Street. It all began with an investor trick known as short selling. Now, the 2016 movie The Big Short had Margot Robbie in a bath explaining how short selling works, but Margot wasn't available. So we've got Susie Youssef in a shower.
Fair swap. So shorting works like this.
Investors borrow stocks they don't actually own, then sell them on to another investor at market price, let's say 10 bucks. Then they wait for the stock to plummet down to 3 bucks and buy it back. They've just made a $7 profit without having to lift a finger.
Shorting is also the term for when you pay Margot Robbie money, but you end up with me.
So Wall Street heavyweights pounced on GameStop, borrowing more than they could ever buy back, with the expectation that its imminent collapse would make them all rich.
Greed is good.
But they didn't count on one thing, the internet. Millions of users on worldwide mega forum Reddit saw what Wall Street was up to and decided to step in and buy up big. There were so many of them, GameStop's stock climbed by 1,000% in just 1 week.
The rally on GameStop and other stocks is really unprecedented. Some people are making money, but it's to really stick it to Wall Street and the establishment.
Because the stock went so high, short sellers are facing a loss of more than $90 billion, and Wall Street is panicking. Even the White House has taken notice.
But our team is, of course, monitoring the situation.
Some brokers, including the Redditor's weapon of choice, Robinhood, have tried to pour water on the fire, suspending trading of the stock, triggering anger and protests.
They're screwing us over. And we're angry.
This is the first time, but it certainly won't be the last time that we see the internet rally around a stock like this.
But for some of these big hedge funds, the window to sell short is about to expire. So has the internet just figured out how to beat Wall Street at its own game, or does the house always win?
Well, here to explain what happens next is our own Wolf of Wall Street, Dan Ziffer. Dan, what the hell just happened?
Well, in short, the internet. You know, it's not just for cat videos. It might also bring down capitalism. What we've seen is, like, all these different ways, really diverse ways that the internet has brought together millions of people to promote change. So everything from the Arab Spring to the way that it's recruited people for shareholder class actions or democratised the way that people can contribute to political campaigns. So what it's done is kind of unleashed this, you know, broad army of people just kind of looking for something to do. And what they've decided is to kind of punch Wall Street in the face. Now, you had a really good explanation there of shorting. And essentially what they've done is they've created this situation where companies have taken a massive bet that the price was going to fall, and now they're on the hook for billions. So we just don't know what's going to happen, but it is absolutely fascinating.
Well, do you think any company is going to want to take the risk of shorting going forward, knowing that a bunch of people on the internet can literally just take them for billions?
But shorting is something that happens to companies. Companies don't do it themselves. So today, the price of, you know, Australia's biggest listed funeral company went down about almost 10%. And that's not because there's going to be 10% fewer funerals next year. It's because it was one of the most shorted stocks and people bought it up trying to create the same effect that's happening with GameStop in the US. So GameStop doesn't make any money. The share price used to be a function of how much it made, how much its real estate was worth, and what its prospects were. What happened here is the internet has totally ripped that up, and to make a point, they've caused the share price to soar to kind of punch Wall Street in the nose and get their attention and really affect some change.
So, Dan, this has really pulled open the curtain for a lot of people on how Wall Street actually operates. It's not pretty. So is there going to be any fallout from this?
People are going to lose money. We do not know who. This is the thing. So there's no way that stocks can go up or down without a kind of transfer of wealth. What this has done is not just created this situation, but it's meant that this will happen again. You know, people will weaponize this kind of movement to take on certain companies, to take on certain positions. So this is really just the start. And I know we've spent a lot of time this week talking about a failing US computer game chain, but that's because it is a much bigger story about how the market can be changed and manipulated and moved by millions of kind of disorganized people just looking for lulls.
Well, Dan, obviously I understood every word, but I'm just going to ask for a friend of mine. Can you explain it all from the top again?
So GameStop is a US company that's not doing very well.
don't do that for us, Dan. But just, you know, as short as you can, does this spell the end of shorting because of the damage that can be done to the hedge funds that do it?
Well, that will depend on changes to regulation. It probably won't, because shorting is something that needs to happen in the market. People need to be able to buy shares because they think the price is going to go up, in the same way as they need to be able to do something that says, look, I think it's going to go down. But what we've seen here is it's been kind of gone nuclear and used to make a point. You know, the share price is far beyond what the company is worth. It's being used to prove something and to cause a lot of damage. So there might be changes to the way that shorting is done to try and prevent this wild volatility from exploding different companies.
Dan, you almost made finance interesting. The key word there, almost. Thanks so much for your time.
All the best.
Yeah, well, call me crazy, but I'll be holding on to my Video Easy stocks for a few more years, thank you.
Now, if you... From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.